The Russian Berlinale entry is titled A Long and Happy Life, but tells a grim tale of corruption, greed and pride. It's about one man's abrupt coming of age and is set in the rural north. A sort of Russian Western, as the director explains.
This
is not just a remake, rather it's a sort of contemplation on the topic of the film High Noon and how it could have been remade Russian style, and who would be the enemy and who would be the hero. When I started thinking about it, I realized that in the Russian situation, there could be no absolute evil and absolute good. Everything is totally mixed.
Не может быть абсолютного зла и абсолютного добра, и все это очень сильно перемешано.
В общем, Денис Сергеевич потом реально был в панике.
Alexander Yatsenko plays Sasha, a reluctant community leader who's forced to backtrack on a sale of land to the government, a decision that has dire consequences for everyone involved. Shot on a handheld digital camera in natural light, the film may be in the running for a cinematography prize. But for the cameraman, there's much more at stake. There's a very popular phrase, revolution or death. There is either going to be the decay and death of the nation, which will be robbed by thieves in power, or there will be a real change of the political system. And most likely, it'll happen through revolution.
Смена политического строя, и она будет, скорее всего, революционная.
Which path is more real, I can't judge. But it seems to me, and I hope, that changes in Russia will happen sooner than we think. Along with Boris Klebnikov's previous films, Free Floating and Help Gone Mad, A Long and Happy Life forms a trilogy about the inevitability of choice.
Скоро будешь работать, Саш. Ты знаешь, как жизнь завертится, когда ты переедешь?
Да нет, все равно картошку надо убрать. Я не хочу совсем без денег приезжать. Там еще работа и работа.